Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to GMHL Action, where tonight the Shelburne Red Wings host the Bob Cajun Bucks. Welcome to the pregame show. I'm Bob Bernstein, here overlooking a beautiful rink. And my first guest tonight is Julian Cimini, a goalie for the Shelburne Red Wings. And Julian, welcome to the show. I understand it's your first year in the league. How are you enjoying it so far?
Yeah, it's a good time in the league. It's a nice league. The level is competitive, and it's a good league to go in pro college.
Yes, it is. We put over 100 players through to NCAA Division 1 to 3. Julian, tell us a little bit about your hockey background before coming to the GMHL.
Before coming to this league, I played in Italy in the second and under 20. Then a few years before, I played Italy 3, a few games, and yeah.
Okay. And how has the league met your expectations so far? How are you enjoying it?
Well, I'm enjoying it good. It's a pretty good league. It's competitive. Teams are even, so every team can beat every team anytime. So it's a good hockey that you can see.
Yeah, and it's getting better all the time. So you've seen some good action so far, but I guess we could say a little bit more limited action, appearing in 5 games so far. How does a goalie stay sharp in between starts so that when you are called upon, you're ready to go?
I just try to get 100% in practice, and if it's game time, get ready, go in, do my job, make some good saves, and help the team to get the win.
Okay, good. What are your goals looking forward, playing more years here in the NHL and then going on to other hockey? What do you want to do afterward?
I want to do after. Try to get a college spot, NCAA, CIS, or getting pro, depends. But my first point to go is college, to get an education, and after that, see what happens.
Sure. And how have you done picking up pointers from the other goalies, like Anton Todakov? He's pretty good.
Yeah, he's being next to him in practice makes you do even better, that you look same as good as him. And yeah, he helps a lot to improve your game, because it's a good goalie, so you have to do good too.
Okay, good. What specific parts of your game are you concentrating on to really improve and make yourself that much better?
I try to play smart. First of all, you don't spend energy to do stuff that you don't need. Just be in time, make the save, and that's it.
Good. Well, I want to thank you very much for coming on our show, and I want to wish you all the best of luck the rest of the way. Thank you very much, Julian.
Thank you.
That's Julian Cimini, goaltender for the Shelburne Red Wings. Stay tuned, folks. We're going to bring you all the action in just a few minutes. Okay. We're just about to have the national anthem, and then these two teams will be all set to go in exciting GMHL action. We'll bring it to you right after our national anthem. All right, so the anthem's in, the fans are settling into their seats, and we're going to have all the GMHL action for you. Starting in goal for the Red Wings, it'll be number one, Anton Todakov. And for the Bob Cage and Bucks, also number one, Ila Zurin. Starting up front for the Red Wings will be Bezant, Opatrini, and Verana. On defense, we've got, looks like Bezant is starting on D, along with number 13, Kabelka. Puck's drop, off the drop, Anderson fights for it for Bob Cajun. It's slid into the Bob Cajun zone, back for it now is Grubaker. He dumps it out to center. Bezant has it there. Fires it back into the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun looking, coming out of their zone now. That pass is intercepted. Kabelka puts it back behind his own goal to Bezant. Round the horn for Verana. Red Wings are off. Fire it into the Bob Cajun zone. There's a battle for it in the corner. And it's cleared to an open wing. Moving up is Ozilinch now. He takes a shot, another shot. And Verana stopped that. It's dumped out to center and back into the Shelburne zone. Shelburne coming out with it, but lost it. It's along the far boards. There's a battle for it. Tim Camden tries to get it out. Has a second try and does. He slides it to center. It's cleared into the Bob Cajun zone. Igorov takes a shot from a sharp angle, and Zurin stopped that, and there'll be no further play. We're just nicely underway, 18:49 to go in the first period, looking for our first goal. Face-off to the left of Zurin. There's a shot right off the face-off, and it's stopped and held again, and we'll do it all over again. Up front is Tim Camden taking the draw for Shelburne. He wins the draw. It's played to an open wing. Bob Cajun gains possession, comes out the center to the Red Wing line, circling behind the goal now. A centering pass, that didn't work. Now it goes back to the point. Armstrong trying to keep it in, but it's slid out by Ozilinch to the central neutral zone. Bob Cajun trying to mount an attack. Puck is stopped there, but they gain possession coming in, but it's offside. Looked like Bartley had a chance to jump in there, but the play was preceded by an over-anxious winger, and so the puck's coming all the way back now into the Bob Cajun zone. Coming out's the big line for the Red Wings. Opatrini, Verana. The puck was dropped unfairly, so we'll do it again. Opatrini moving in for the faceoff. From the draw, it goes back behind the Bob Cajun zone. They tried to clear it out, but couldn't. There's a battle along the near side boards, and the puck has slid down the ice. No icing. Todakov comes out of his goal to play it. Plays it on the far wing for Kabelka. He stops, slides it over to Bezant. Bezant shoots it into the Bob Cajun zone. In there on the forecheck is Verana. It's back at the point, kept in by Kabelka on the left side, right in front of Verana, shot. And once again, Zurin is equal to the challenge. And he looks sharp and didn't allow a rebound, holds for a faceoff, no further play. Bob Cajun on a penalty here, 1:26 left to go in that. Red Wings trying to get the first tally of the game on the power play. There's a delayed offside. Behind the net now, Grauberger fires it out to center. Bezant gets it there. He's bodied, but fires it in, but it's offside. Face-off is actually going to be in the Bob Cajun zone as it went off a Bob Cajun player out of play. Tim Camden moves up to take the face-off for Shelburne. He loses the draw, and the puck's cleared the length of the ice. Here's Ozilinch with it in the corner. He's being watched. Puck slides behind the Shelburne goal. It's shot out to center where Taylor gets it and fires it right back into the Shelburne zone. Good job on the penalty kill by Bob Cajun here. Ozelinch had some trouble with it. There's a three-man battle on the far wing. But now the Red Wings gain possession and clear it out. Taylor steps into Levesque and that rush was stopped. Puck now on the far side boards. Bob Cajun trying to get it out of the zone. 25 seconds left to go in the Shelburne power play. Not much happened with it so far. And Bob Cajun fires it down the ice yet again. Todakoff, a long pass over center. That works. Here's Bennington trying his luck. He centers it for Ozelinch. It went off his skate. And Bob Cajun clears it out, but barely. Now they get the puck again, and play is called. What do we have here? Looks like an offside. Face-off outside the Bob Cajun zone. Only 5 seconds left to go in the first period. In the penalty, 16:25 left to go in the first period. Still no score. Out for the Red Wings, we have Ostoski at center. And we have Serpik on left wing and Igorov on right wing. Patterson gets it for Bob Cajun and flips it over the glass, so we'll have another face-off in the neutral zone. Penalty now just expired, so Bob Cajun's back at full strength. Face-off once again just outside the Bob Cajun blue line. Pucks drop, Red Wings, Zub clears it into the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun garners it there, looking to come out with it, having some difficulty, trying again along the side. Patterson just moves it ahead. It's kept in by Cassidy. Bob Cajun puts it on the boards out to center. Zub tries to stop it, but Bob Cajun carries on, and only to have it them checked. Serpik gets it, goes in, wrist shot, and another save by Zurin. Face-off to come to his left in the Bob Cajun zone. Teams make wholesale changes. Looks like Opatrini's coming out. We have
two penalties.
Offsetting penalties coming up. Nope. Faceoff coming all the way down into the Shelburne zone. Verana wins the faceoff. Kubelka fires it the length of the ice as Shelburne took a penalty. I didn't see what the call was. We'll try and get that for you. Bob Cajun now coming out on the power play. Up into the neutral zone. It's tipped in to the Shelburne zone. Bazant has it there behind the net. Bob Cajun moves up on the forecheck. Stops it at the point. It's shot around the boards. Stopped at the other point. Now it's behind the net. Two Bob Cajun players forechecking there. It's kept in momentarily. Now the Wings get it out to center ice. Bob Cajun fires it right back in again. Todakoff takes it on his own shoulders and fires it the length of the ice. Good play there by the big Red Wing goalie. Bob Cajun fires it the length of the ice. There's no icing here. It's been waved off. Bazant behind his goal, being watched there by Skillicorn. There's still a battle for it, the same two. Bazant gets it, banks it off the boards and down the ice. Zurin leaving it there for Taylor. Bob Cajun making wholesale changes, and the Red Wings change their penalty unit. Now it's shot in behind the Red Wing net and around the horn, kept in at the point momentarily. It did squeak out, brought it back in, and it's offside at the Shelburne line. Taylor tried to hold it in but couldn't, and then they brought it in prematurely, so the offside. 14:26 to go, first period, still no score. Owen Bennington taking the shorthanded faceoff for Shelburne. It's won by Bob Cajun. They fire it back in again. Todakoff behind his net fires it around the boards, but not out. Now it does come out again, as Taylor once again couldn't keep it in. Now Grauberger tries to flip it down, gets it back again. He's all the way behind his own net. Bob Cajun leading a rush, coming out with it. They're at center ice. Now they've gained the Shelburne blue line. There's a quick shot that went off a stick and wide as Kufis tried his shot, but a Red Wing defenseman got a stick on it. The play is called. The face-off in the Red Wing zone to the left of Anton Tatarkov. Tim Camden comes out with Cassidy, Igorov, and it's won back by Shelburne around the horn. Igorov has it there, fires it to the Bob Cajun blue line. Bob Cajun circling back with it. It's Clancy. He fired it around the wing. Now it's back behind the Bob Cajun goal again as they look to come out with it. And they do. Bob Cajun at the blue line. At the Red Wing line, a shot. Tatarkov easily gloves that and holds on. No further play. The faceoff coming again to the left of Anton Tatarkov as the Red Wings return to full strength. We've got Tim Camden with Serpek. Cassidy is on defense. We've got Igorov with the puck off the draw, going back behind his net. Now Red Wings deliberately trying to come out with it, banked off the boards to the Bob Cajun line. Bob Cajun has it there. It's flipped out to center on a nice pass. A nice move here coming in. And a shot goes over top of the net. Bob Cajun working the far boards, keeping it in the Shelburne zone. It's played back behind the Shelburne net now. It ricochets off a couple bodies, squirts out to the side of the goal, but no further. Back into the far corner. Here's Patterson with it. Big number nine tries to center it. It's intercepted, and back comes Camden to Igorov at the Bob Cajun line. Igorov takes a quick shot. That's a pad save by Zurin. Back to the point, another shot. And that didn't miss by much. Went off a leg and ricocheted out of play. Face off now to the left of goaltender Zurin in the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun sending out Skillicorn. And we'll bring you the other line mates momentarily. Can't quite make out their numbers from here, but puck's drop kept in by the Red Wings. A shot that went wide, came across the goal, and pouncing on it is Zurin and smothers it, as that was one of the best chances we've had so far in the early going. 12:21 to go, first period, still looking for the game's first goal. Face off now to the right of goaltender Zurin. Kabelka and Bezant are on defense for Shelburne. It's chipped out over the Bob Cajun line. Bezant now has it back in his own zone. He flips it ahead. Shelburne trying to work it in the zone, but can't. Now Savkovsky's checked, and there's going to be a penalty to Bob Cajun there. Bennington comes in with a slapper, but the play was offside. Bob Cajun's going to get the gate here. We'll have the call for you. It's a minor penalty. There was no signal whatsoever from the referee as to what that call was. So sorry, don't know what it is. Might be a trip or a hook or a hold. Off the faceoff in the Bob Cajun zone. Shelburne trying to work some magic. Back to Ozilinch on the right point. Varana has it. He puts it across to the left side. Back to Ozilinch. Back into Varana. Quick shot goes off a leg to the corner. Bob Cajun tries to clear it out, and it goes into the bench. So the faceoff will be deep in Bob Cajun's zone. 1:43 left to go in the Bob Cajun minor penalty. 11:41 to go in the first period. Opatrini looking to take the faceoff for Shelburne. He's waved out of the faceoff circle. So it looks like Jurasek will take the draw. It's in the Bob Cajun corner. Ozilinch puts a glove up and knocks it down and is called for a hand pass. Faceoff will come outside the Bob Cajun zone and all the way down into the Shelburne zone. 1:38 to go in the penalty to Bob Cajun. Faceoff to the right of Red Wing goaltender Anton Tarkov. Off the faceoff, Opatrini tries to get it. Now Bennington does, comes out over the blue line to center, gains the Bob Cajun zone, going in. That pass was intercepted and Bob Cajun clears it. Here's a break on the right side. Tarkov comes out and pokes it away neatly. It was a nice play, but it's still in the Shelburne zone at center. Tarkov gets it there and fires it out of harm's way himself. Now Bennington has it. Pass to Ozilinch, to Verana at center. He lost it. Now there's some open ice for a Bob Cajun shorthanded chance, but it's knocked away from Bartley at the last minute. Shelburne a little sloppy, but gaining possession again. Opatrini lost it. Now Bennington has it. He has it at center. Right-hand pass for Verana. That didn't work either. Very scrambly play so far here in the first period. Bazan has it at center. Going to the right side. Gains the Bob Cajun zone. Goes right in. A shot. Nice save there by Zurin as it went off his shoulder and ricocheted to the corner. There's a battle along the near boards. Verana gains it in the offensive zone, centers it. That pass didn't work, and now the puck squirts out and all the way down to the Shelburne blue line. Kabelka has it there. Left wing pass to his partner, Bazant. He tries to hit Kabelka again, and it goes off his skate. Now Serpek will try his luck. Out to center. Tries to squeeze through and does on the left boards into the Bob Cajun zone. There's a battle for it. Four men battling away. Bob Cajun's back at full strength. The puck's poked out to center. Bazan has it there for the Red Wings and fires it back in on goal. Bob Cajun looking to start something. There's a pass at center. Going in over the Shelburne line. A shot. Tarkov made a nice pad save and decided to hold on. And now we've got some tempers flaring between Tim Camden and number three on Bob Cajun, who I don't have a player name for. Faceoff coming in the Shelburne zone. Looks like another penalty coming here to Shelburne. So Tarkov might get tested again. Faceoff to his left. Shelburne wins the draw. Zub fires it around the boards. Not out. Patterson works the near side, but Serpek intercepted his pass and sends it the length of the ice. Back there in the Bob Cajun zone, Patterson has it. He passes it back behind his own net. There's a right side pass that's broken up by Serpek, trying to work a little shorthanded magic. Circles in, still has it. His pass goes off a leg, but he chips it back into the corner and behind the net. Bob Cajun has it there and will try their luck again. That pass was intercepted. Shelburne doing a nice job here on the penalty kill. Puck is shot the length of the ice again by Shelburne. And Bob Cajun's back there for it. Kalugin behind his net sends it up to Patterson over center. Right side pass gains the Shelburne line. A shot goes wide. Patterson passes it back to the point. Here's another shot. That's deflected. And the face-off will be to the right of goaltender Anton Tarkov. 57 seconds left in the Shelburne penalty. 8:30 left in the first period. We're still looking for the opening goal of the game. And play's been a bit scrambly as both teams seem to be feeling each other out at this point. Puck is dropped. Out with it comes Opatrini. He's got a break. He's going in shorthanded. A shot. Oh, and a nice save there. Now Opatrini tried another rush, but that didn't work. Back comes Bob Cajun. There's a pass, goes off a leg to the corner. Clancy with it there, puts it behind the Shelburne net. Now a nice play by Verana, who bumps his man Bartley off the puck and starts a rush at center over the blue line. 27 seconds left in the Shelburne penalty. It's behind the Bob Cajun goal. They're starting out with it. Once again, having trouble coming out of their own zone. Now they do. They're at the Shelburne blue line. Clancy fires a pass over and then gets a return pass. Then his return pass was intercepted in turn. Shelburne fires it out. Opatrini goes after it, but it's just kept out of his clutches. Now Bob Cajun shoots it into the Shelburne zone. Todakoff pokes it there behind the net. Here comes Igorov, dangerously in front of his own net. Ozolinch will try a rush. He fires it the length of the ice. It's stopped there by the goalie. But it looks like because Shelburne was back at full strength, they were called for icing. That's sort of a strange one because the goaltender played it. But nevertheless, the Zebras always have the right call at their hand. Bennington taking the faceoff for Shelburne in his own zone, wins the draw. Kabelka has it, takes it behind the net. He passes it on to his left defense partner, gets it back on the right side, and a dangerous cross-ice pass came out over the line, poked back in, and now Bazant circles in his own zone, passing to Kabelka. He lost it. Kabelka gains it again, goes behind his net. He's being watched closely there by Jelinski. Now a left wing pass goes off Levesque, the length of the ice. No icing. Bob Cajun coming out with it. It's flipped out to center. Kabelka has it there. Stick handling in a phone booth. It's shot to an open wing. And Bob Cajun has it there. Bazant favoring his left shoulders going to the bench. Cassidy has it. He banks it off the boards. Kabelka tips it to Bennington at center. He lost it. Igorov stepped into his man and gains possession, circling and coming out of his own zone. A nice move at the blue line. Up the center, gathering speed. A quick shot goes off a leg wide. Bennington pounces on that rebound. Fires it back to Zeb at the point. It's a delayed offside. And Bob Cajun comes back with it at the Shelburne line. Two-man rush off of Zub, went nowhere. Now Bob Cajun tries to keep it in and can't. Back come the Red Wings, only to lose it inside the Bob Cajun zone. It's shot back to the Red Wing line and over. Todakoff plays it on an open left wing, and back come the Red Wings. Vistovsky had a little trouble getting going with it, was bodied into the boards, but the play was offside at the Bob Cajun line. 5:34 to go, first period. Still no score. Face-off just outside the Bob Cajun line. Bob Cajun wins the draw, circling back with it in their own zone, looking for an open man, trying to come out with it. It's out to center. Bob Cajun gains the Shelburne line. It's flipped by Cassidy out to center. Vistotsky has it there. He's checked. Now it's poked into the Red Wing zone. Cassidy off the boards to Vysotsky. He's coming out the center, in over the line, still has it. Trying to find an open man. He's bodied on the board neatly, and that rush was broken up. Now there's a fight for it at center ice, won by Bob Cajun, coming in over the Red Wing line. There's a shot by Anderson, and that just went wide. Red Wings clear it down the ice. Play continues as the Red Wings make wholesale changes. They pass it back into their own zone. Here's Ozolinch now behind his own goal for safety. Coming out the left side. He banks it off the boards. Jurasek had it there and was bodied hard. And now a heavy check in turn was laid by the Red Wings. Bob Cajun carries right on, tries to go in. That was neatly stopped. Out come the Red Wings again. Here's Verana. On the left side, that pass was broken up. Bob Cajun in the neutral zone now. They turn it over again. Here comes Jurasek. He gains the line with some open ice, a shot, and a good one just wide. He had some open side there on the goaltender, but failed to hit the net. It's backhanded back into the Shelburne corner. Bazant battles there with it. It's just to the side. Patterson tried to center it. That was broken up. Now Opatrini coming back with the Red Wings. Over to Verana with Jurasek in the middle. There's a hard shot, and Verana just missed the open side. Red Wings keep it in. It's back to the point. Ozolinch fighting as he moves up from his defensive spot. Shot by the Red Wings, and it's tipped out of play. The faceoff will be in the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun making changes. They send Taylor out. And Patterson stays out there. Grauberger back on defense with Taylor. Face off to the right of goaltender Zirin. Bennington's taking the draw for the Red Wings. We've got Bezant and Kabelka at the point. Owen wins the draw. The puck's kept in by Bezant at their left point. The puck bounced in front, but alertly was cleared all the way down the ice by Bob Cajun. Icing is waved off at the last minute. Bezant has it along the left side. He banks it off the boards neatly to center. Here come the Red Wings trying a rush. Igorov just failed to break three. Now Kabelka passes to Bezant again. Over to Bennington on the left side, over the line. A shot and a good one. And a nice save there by Zirin as he took it on his right shoulder. Kabelka gives it to Levesque, who backhands it behind the Bob Cajun's net. Patterson has it here on the near side, and he clears it out inside the Shelburne zone. Bezant going back for it. Bezant circling, being watched by two Bob Cajun players. Skillicorn knocked the stick out of his hand. Shelburne loses it at center. Igorov couldn't get started on that rush, and it's backhanded back in behind the Shelburne goal. A battle ensues there. Bob Cajun coming out with a Skillicorn behind the net. Centers it. Oh, a good save there by Anton Todakov. And then he got chopped by a stick of Bob Cajun, who was trying to swat at the rebound. And he's got a problem with his right hand. He's going to the Shelburne bench. We'll have to see if he can shake that one off. But that hurt. 2:11 to go, first period. No score. Faceoff coming to the right of what we hope will be a returning Anton Todakov in the Shelburne net. Still favoring that right hand. Looks like the fingers took a good chop as the Bob Cajun player wasn't trying to hurt him. He was trying to bang away at the loose puck on the rebound, but Anton was quick as a cat on that one, as he had to react to a very quick play forming in front of him, and he managed to get that big 6'5" frame in front of it and then gloved it. And that's when the Bob Cajun player took a swat at it and he hurt his hand. Referee now talking to Todakov, standing just on the ice surface at the Red Wing bench. Referee urging him to go off or go back in the net. We'll see which one it's going to be. He's leaving the ice, and Babernak, number 29, is at least temporarily going into the net for Shelburne. We'll have to keep an eye on that. Hopefully it's nothing serious to Anton Todakov, as the Red Wings can ill afford to lose their fine netminder. However, Babernak has had some great games himself, and it's his responsibility now for at least the time being. Puck's dropped. Camden fighting for the puck. It squirts loose. Bob Cajun gets it in the corner here. It's intercepted by Serpek. His pass was behind number 8, Nikitin. It's dumped back into the Shelburne zone. Fired around the horn, kept in at the point by Bob Cajun. Jelinski slides a pass in on the near side. Bob Cajun playing tic-tac-toe back behind the Red Wing net. Nikita now circles for the Red Wings, has it. Makes a nice move. Tries to hit Serpik, but gets it back again and comes out. Play shot into the Bob Cajun zone as Camden fired it in. Bob Cajun coming right back out with it. Now that it's intercepted, Shelburne coming in, a rebound. And that was also gobbled up. Now Bob Cajun still having trouble getting out. It's kept in. The left side, there's a battle ensuing. Camden on the ice, trying to pass it from there, but couldn't. And it's flipped out and all the way down the ice. And Babernak comes out and grabs it, and there'll be no further play. We're in the final minute of the first stanza. 59.3 seconds to go. 0-0 the score, Shelburne Red Wings and Bob Cajun Bucks. I'm Bob Bernstein, bringing you the action here from the Shelburne Rink, the South Dufferin County Recreation Center. It's a beautiful facility. And we're here in Broadcast Center. Off the face-off, Ozilinch fires it around the horn. Red Wings get it out to center. Bob Cajun backhands it right back in. Ozilinch here tips it to his point man, but that was intercepted. Now they'll try it again, but that puck was intercepted by Taylor. Bob Cajun has two Taylors, number 4 and 39, and this was the latter that had the puck there. Now the Red Wings bring it in offside, and the play is stopped. Face-off outside the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun making changes here for the last 30.9 seconds of the first period. Hopatrini for the Red Wings. Gathers it for Jurasek. He goes in on the left side. He's immediately challenged and bodied off the puck. Bob Cajun brings it back to the Shelburne line. A neat move here by Bob Cajun, but puck was knocked off the opposing player's stick. Now they're trying to get it back to the point and do a shot, and Babernak stopped that. Clancy couldn't get the rebound. Fights with it along the side with Jurasek. Now a stick is knocked out of the way that had been dropped, and at the last minute, Ozilinch is getting an interference penalty. As the buzzer expires, the buzzer goes off and the first period expires. No score at the end of one. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back to bring you all the action of the second period in just a few minutes. See you then. Okay, the teams are back for the middle stanza. Still no score. Red Wings starting the second period a man short as Ozilinch took an interference penalty as time expired as he slid one of the Bob Cajun player's sticks out of the way as it was lying on the ice. Off the faceoff, Shelburne dumps it to the Bob Cajun line. Taylor's there, fires it into the Shelburne net. Todakoff was back in goal, fires it up. There's a shot on net. He gloves it. And here comes Shelburne, 2-on-1, shorthanded. There's a quick shot, not much on it. Opatrini tries to get it behind the net. Now Verana has it. Jelinski had it for Bob Cajun, now gets it back again. Trying to mount an attack. Behind the net here for Taylor. Taylor organizing a rush, but gets checked by Verana, back to the point. There's a shorthanded shot. Oh, and it's tipped right on. Another shot just goes wide. And that's the best chance of this game for either team. And it comes shorthanded for Shelburne. Now Bob Cajun has it in the Shelburne zone. But they're checked quickly and it's cleared back out. Nice job by the Red Wings here on the penalty kill. They have it again going on the offensive zone. Bazan takes a shot that goes off a leg. It's cleared behind the goal. Opatrini up there on a aggressive forecheck, shorthanded. Bob Cajun gets it to center, goes off Jelinski's skate. They carry on, however, into the Shelburne zone. Jelinski has it in the center, a quick shot, and it went wide of the goal. Verana now, on the end of a long shift, dumps it out to Opatrini. It's carried in. Verana takes a shot, shorthanded. Nice save there by Zurin. Bob Cajun's had a been kind of careless on the power play so far. Jelinski overskates the puck now. Now Armstrong carries on for Bob Cajun. There's a hard shot. Todakoff stopped that. A dangerous rebound in the middle of the ice. Bob Cajun still has it with 2 seconds left in the penalty. A quick shot. Now it's cleared out. Ozilinch just out of the box has a breakaway. Tough angle coming in. Shot. Nice save by Zurin as he extended that right pad and was equal to the tough challenge. Now Bob Cajun skedaddles out of their zone, coming into the Shelburne, a sharp angle shot, easily stopped by Todakoff. A rebound comes out, Patterson takes a poke at it, and Todakoff hopped on the rebound to make sure nothing dangerous happened from there. But big Patterson there, 6'6", 270, was ever dangerous in front of the net. He's got 13 goals and 23 assists so far this year, leading all Bob Cajun scorers. Off the faceoff, Bob Cajun gets it. Here's Bartley coming in. A drop pass didn't work. Now Shelburne trying to clear it out but can't. Bartley goes into the left wing on the forecheck in the corner. It's comes around the boards, a sharp angle shot, didn't work. There's a quick shot from another bad angle, and that didn't work either. Shelburne now trying to dig it out and get out of their zone. They're stopped again, but a second try flips it down the ice. Bob Cajun gets it there, fires it back into the Shelburne zone. Zub trying to come out with it. He's checked. Now it's behind the net. Bartley on the forecheck on the near side corner. Nice body check by Zub stops that initiative. Now Bennington plays a long right wing pass. Out of the zone comes Levac. He just shoots it in. Bob Cajun tips it out to center. But now they're coming in on a sharp angle. He's in alone. But the scoring chance didn't materialize as a nice back check prevented that from happening. Now Shelburne coming out with it. Play is called. It looks like we're going to have penalties here. As there's a discussion with the referees, but I believe both teams are getting one. Let's see what the calls are here. A slash, two slashing penalties, one to each team. Faceoff will be outside the Bob Cajun zone. There'll be 4-on-4 hockey for 2 minutes. We're just nicely underway here in the middle frame. Still no score. Bob Cajun sending out Cameron Anderson. Puck's back in the Bob Cajun zone. Goes to the point. A wrist shot by Shelburne. That goes wide, and then Zurin hops on the rebound to prevent any further play. Faceoff will be in the Bob Cajun zone. Opatrini with Verana, Bezant and Kabelka for the Red Wings. Here comes Anderson out with it for Bob Cajun. It's at center, intercepted by Verana. He circles back into his own zone. The Red Wings fire it to an open boards. It's gobbled up by Bob Cajun. Fired into the offensive corner in the Shelburne zone. Shelburne trying to come out with it. That's stopped. Bob Cajun looking to do something dangerous here. And a shot goes off a leg. Coming back to the point now. And Shelburne breaks out with it. Here's Opatrini to Verana. Shot. Nice save by Zurin. Another shot back from the point and a sharp glove save. He couldn't hold it, but he got a piece of it, and it was just enough to deflect it into the meshing. Play was called, but another two fine saves there by Ilya Zurin, the Bob Cajun netminder, who's looked very sharp tonight. Faceoff to his left, deep in the Bob Cajun zone. Red Wings send out Tim Camden, along with Jurasek. Puck's dropped. Camden has it, trying to find someone to pass it to. He's checked, and out comes Taylor for Bob Cajun. Along the left side, he's brought to the ice. Play carries on. It's in the Shelburne zone. Ozilinch gets it and circles. Tries to hit a red wing at center, and that pass was too far. Bob Cajun gets control again. They have it in their own zone. Armstrong. A pass for Taylor at center. He gains the Shelburne zone, has Armstrong on the right wing, takes a shot, pad saved by Todorkov, and a good one. Now it's centered right in front, but that's intercepted by Shelburne, and they come out to center. A pass there was intercepted. However, second effort carried on. Here's a hard shot by Camden, and once again, Zurin stops it, and there's no rebound, and he holds it for no further play. 16 seconds left in the coincidental minors. Face off to the right of Zurin. And that's when you know a goaltender's really on, when he makes good, tough saves and there's no rebounds on him. Play carries on and now is called again. Skillicorn had lost his stick and is heading to the penalty box. Looks like a high stick to him. So the Red Wings will go on the power play, 4-on-3 for the next 11 seconds, and then it'll be 5-on-4 when both players return. Owen Bennington takes the offensive faceoff for Shelburne. Anderson splits the draw with him. The puck is cleared out to just over the line. Bennington circles back with it, hops in over the line. Play is called again. I'm not sure why the play was called there, but it has been called. Faceoff outside the Bob Cajun zone. It didn't look like anyone was offside, but perhaps it was a hand pass, and that's why they called it. Cody Clancy at center for Bob Cajun on this 4-on-3 that only has 2 seconds left in it before it goes to a 5-on-4 power play. Off the draw, Bob Cajun weakly backhands at the center. It's gobbled up by the Red Wings. They gain the zone, and it's offside. Very close call there at the Bob Cajun blue line. So we have 5-on-4 now for the next minute 44. Shelburne trying to break the scoreless tie. Igorov passes it back to the defense on the draw. It's backhanded partway into the Bob Cajun zone. Taylor gloves it back and fires it down the ice. Todakov stopping it there behind his goal. Fakes a pass neatly and leaves it there for the Red Wings, who will try and mount a power play rush here. Igorov is stopped as he tried to come out. However, they carry on. On the near side here, it's Bennington. A wrist shot. Stopped by Zurin. Rebound. He doesn't know where it is, but he leans back on the ice. Spread eagle. It was still under him, and the play is called. He lost sight of it for a minute, did Zurin, looking behind him and all around, but the puck stayed lodged underneath him, fortunately for him and the Bucks. Face-off to his right, deep in the Bob Cajun zone. Off the face-off, Opotrini was knocked down, and the puck was shot into the Shelburne bench, so we'll do it all over again. 13:38 left in the second period, still no score. 1:08 left in the Shelburne power play, or less, if they can find the back of the net here. Opotrini, Jurasek, and Verana on the forward line for Shelburne. However, Bob Cajun wins the draw. It's fired around the boards and out to center. Taylor has it on the left side, coming in on a shorthanded rush. A shot! Todakov looked behind him, but it wasn't on the net. It ricochets out of play, and we'll have a face-off this time in the Shelburne end to the left of Anton Todakov. 57 seconds left in the Shelburne power play. 13:27 to go, second period. Still looking for the game's first marker. Back to the point. Bob Cajun fires it in, and it goes out of play. So the faceoff will be outside the zone now. And another faceoff coming up. We've got Bartley. We've got Glasbergen up front for Bob Cajun. Faceoff coming just outside the Shelburne blue line. Puck's dropped. Shelburne wins the draw. Circling in back in their own zone behind the net. There's a pass here. Fired back behind the net again. Verana gobbles it up there. Stops behind his goal and now organizes a rush. Starting out with good speed at the neutral zone. Nice move to gain the Bob Cajun line. Goes left on the defense. Goes back behind the net. Looking for someone to pass to. Back to the point. Back to Verana here on the near side. To Jurasek, a shot. And that was high and wide. Jurasek has it again. He passes it across. Now another pass was intercepted. And now in turn, Ozolinch intercepts and keeps it in at the point. A hard shot. And that was deflected and goes out of play. Nice save again by Zurin, as he was quick as a cat on that hard wrist shot from the point by Ozolin. Faceoff now coming outside the Bob Cajun zone. Only 8 seconds left in the power play before Bob Cajun comes back to full strength. Jelinski wins the draw for Bob Cajun. However, it's in the Bob Cajun zone. There's a hard shot, and that didn't miss by much. Firing that was Jurasek. Now Jelinski starts out. He passes it up to Skillicorn. A return pass for Jelinski doesn't work. There's a delayed call to Shelburne. The goalie started out, but Shelburne touches the puck. And we have a penalty coming to Shelburne. So it looks like Ozilinch again, two or less for slashing. So Bob Cajun with a golden opportunity now to break this scoreless tie. He'll be going on the power play. They send out Armstrong and Gillespie and big number nine, Patterson. Off the faceoff, it hops over the boards and we'll do it again, this time outside the Shelburne line. And that took all of 3 seconds, 1:57 to go in the power play. Off the faceoff, Shelburne clears it the length of the ice. Back for it is Armstrong, behind his own goal, looking to organize a rush. He leaves it for Gillespie. Back to Armstrong inside the Bob Cajun zone. That didn't work, so he tries it again. Out to center to Patterson. He circles. Passes it to Gillespie. He's in over the Shelburne line on the left side, trying to work his way to the middle. Here comes Patterson, a backhand shot. And Todakov stopped that. The battle rages on in the Shelburne zone, and now temporarily as it's cleared out to center. Armstrong has it back at his own Bob Cajun blue line. Passes to Big Patterson. Now Bob Cajun coming out with it. Out center, Gillespie gains the Shelburne line on the offensive power play. A shot. Todakov stopped that. Rebound goes harmlessly to the corner. There's a battle for it there. Bob Cajun, Gillespie trying to come out with it. He stopped. Todakov hangs on. And the faceoff will be to the right of Todakov, deep in the Shelburne zone. Shelburne making wholesale changes. Nikitin, Owen Bennington, Bezant, and Kabelka coming out for them. We've got Grauberger and Taylor at the point with Skillicorn up front for Bob Cajun. A shot by Taylor off the faceoff. Oh, a nice pad save by Todakov. Grauberger comes in, another shot. Oh, and another save. He gets a third chance. Another penalty coming to Shelburne. They finally gain possession. And there's a holding call coming up. So the Red Wings will now be two men down for the next 40 seconds or less. Who's getting the gate this time? Looks like Bezant for the Red Wings. Shelburne sending out Berninghausen on the two-man disadvantage. Off the face-off. Won by Bob Cajun, a shot. Todakov looked behind him momentarily, but the shot was wide. Gains the puck and holds it. No further play. 35 seconds left in the two-man advantage for Bob Cajun. Face off to the right of Todakov. Off the draw. It's tied and a scrum develops along the far side. Bob Cajun digs it out. Back to the right point to Taylor. He takes a shot. That went wide. Grauberger with a big shot from the left point. That's going to come out all the way to center ice. Taylor garners it there. Over on the left side to Skillicorn. A shot right on. Todakov stops that. Bennington clears the blue line with the rebound. And now it's cleared the length of the ice by the Red Wings. Big, big clear out there. The penalty, the first penalty to Shelburne's expiring right now. So they're one man down, it's 5-on-4. Skillicorn for Bob Cajun at the blue line. A weak shot goes wide. Shelburne gathers up the rebound, comes straight out at center. On the right side, here comes Verana. He's checked. Taylor comes and feeds a pass to Anderson. That didn't work. Now Kabelka fires it back to his defense partner, Bezant, but he couldn't get it out, and Taylor gobbled up that ill-advised pass. Now the other Taylor tries to keep it in but can't. Back come the Red Wings. Verana has it here. Nice move as he dragged the puck back and then took a shot, but it was wide. Grauberger flips it but not out. Verana tried to hit Jarasek with it. He has it in the corner. Tries to hit Verana. That didn't work. Now he banks a pass back to the point, and that didn't work, and Taylor has a breakaway, going in on the power play, a shot, oh, and he fired it high and wide and over the glass. Not sure if Todakoff got a piece of it. I think the shot missed the mark. But a good, good scoring chance there for Bob Cajun. Face off to the left of Todakoff. 20 seconds to go in the penalty to Shelburne. Off the face off. Bob Cajun wins it. Clancy comes out with a shot. Blocker save there by Todakoff. Clancy again with it. Tries to work a give and go in the corner. That was broken up. Ozilinch takes his man. Now the puck is gobbled up. A chance for the Red Wings are shorthanded. They're coming in, but couldn't make anything happen with it. Back now Bartley. He's checked in the neutral zone. Over the line comes Opatrini again. In the offensive corner. He drags it back. Still has it. Looking for a teammate. Finds it in the slot. Igorov took a weak backhand, and that was wide. There's a penalty coming up to Bob Cajun now. They gain control finally, and here's the call. It looks like a high stick. We'll see if it's a two-minute variety or more. Probably 2 minutes, but we'll let you know shortly. And it looks like big number 20, Kalugin, for Bob Cajun. Is getting the gate here. Owen Bennington moving in on the offensive faceoff deep in the Bob Cajun zone to the left of Zurin. He's joined by big number 93, Levesque. Pucks drop. Red Wings keeping it in the zone. It comes over here to Kabilka. That shot deflected over the boards, but looks like nobody touched it, so it's coming outside the Bob Cajun zone. 1:53 to go in this young power play for the Shelburne Red Wings, trying to draw first blood. 8:28 left to go here in the second period. Bob Cajun has it behind the goal, but loses it to Bennington. He's circling out to the faceoff dot. Feeds it on the right point. Bazant clears it in to Serpek. Back to Bazant. Nice move there. Still has it at that point position. Now it comes out over the blue line as he tried to be just a little too cute with it. Kabelko now hits Varana at center. Coming in rather that Serpik, a shot off a leg. Levesque tries to get it. It's deflected out to center where Kabelko goes back for it. Trying to organize a good rush here. Backhand pass at center. Carried in over the line now by Shelburne. Kabelka has it behind the net. He circles. Bennington now has it. A centering pass. That didn't work. Jelinski tries to hop on a loose puck at center and does. Now he's checked at the last minute by Kabelka, who takes it to safer havens behind his own net. Shelburne coming out on the power play. 45 seconds to go. Here's Bennington coming in. A one-man rush didn't work. It's cleared but not out. Here's a hard shot from the point. Rebound right in front comes back to them. But that shot deflected off the goaltender and out of play. Another nice save by Zurin and a golden opportunity as Levesque had a couple of good chances in the slot but failed to find the twine behind Zurin. 33 seconds to go in the penalty. Face off to the left at Zurin. Bob Cajun has both Taylors out on the ice and Bartley. They win the draw. Fire it out to center. Taylor comes in with it. That's Kevin Taylor, 39. He's in the offensive zone, killing time nicely for Bob Cajun. 20 seconds to go in the power play. They're still banging away at it. And finally, the play is called. And we'll have a face-off in the Shelburne zone. Bob Cajun making some changes. Gillespie comes out now for the final 18 seconds of the penalty kill. He's got Taylor behind him at the point. Wins the faceoff. Patterson now has it for Bob Cajun at center. And he takes his time and backhands it to the Shelburne line. Here comes Shelburne now. Nice move at the line. Oh, and it was just offside as Opatrini showed some nice hands there. But when he dragged the puck back and went around the Bob Cajun defenseman, his teammate was just ahead of him, offside. 3 seconds to go in the Bob Cajun penalty. Puck's dropped. Gillespie has it over the center. Bob Cajun back at full strength now. A battle ensues at the Shelburne line. Now Shelburne gains the Bob Cajun zone and fires it in. It's knocked right back out to the neutral zone just over the Bob Cajun line. Ozilinch battling there for it. Backhands it in, but not too far. Now there's a penalty coming to Shelburne, where somebody is getting charged with an elbow here. Looks like it might be Bob Cajun. But they called the play when Shelburne had the puck. So that's why I thought it might be Shelburne. It looks like it is going to Shelburne as the faceoff's coming down into their zone. Opatrini looks quizzically at the referees. There's some confusion as to who the guilty party is. It's Opatrini. Camden coming out for Shelburne to take the faceoff. Now he's back on defense. Puck squirts back to Anton right off the faceoff, and he holds it. And that took all of 1 second. We'll do it all over again from the same point. Gillespie at center for Bob Cajun. He's with Big Patterson. Back to the point to Taylor. A shot. The rebound right in front of the goal. Oh, a nice chance there for Bob Cajun. But Anton jumps on a loose puck and holds it. And there'll be no further play. 1:51 to go in the penalty. 6:05 to go in the second period, and there's still no score. Referee now coming over to the players' bench, said something, returns to his position. Shelburne gets the puck off the faceoff and fires it down the ice. It stopped there. Behind the net now, Bob Cajun's Taylor, number 4, coming out with a long pass for Moulton, and that failed to click. However, it's in the Shelburne zone. Bob Cajun has it there, deep in the corner. There's a battle for it behind the net. The puck's still free, and it's still along the boards as 4 players, 2 from each side, try and get it loose. Play carries on. Shelburne back to the point, but couldn't get it out. A weak shot goes to the open corner. Shelburne once again trying to get it out, and this time it's poked out and down into the Bob Cajun zone. Varane on an aggressive forecheck. Didn't have the opportunity present itself. Grauberger back for Bob Cajun. Flips it into the offensive zone. Big Patterson has it there. Centered in front, a shot. Oh, and Anton was caught going the wrong way, but the puck was wide. Bob Cajun looking a little more dangerous on this power play so far. Back to the point. A shot along the ice is steered neatly away by Todakov. Now Shelburne trying to get it out, but can't. A pass is blocked nicely. It's shot around the horn, but kept in at the point by Grauberger. A long shot. It's tipped, but that didn't find the net. Anton has it, holds it, and no further action. 26 seconds to go in this Bob Cajun power play. Wholesale changes for both teams. Out over the boards for Shelburne comes Owen Bennington, Bezant, Serpik. And for Bob Cajun, we have Cody Clancy. We have Patterson off the draw. Puck in the Shelburne zone. A good shot was stopped by Todakov there at the right point. Bob Cajun keeps it in. 16 seconds left in the penalty. Now Shelburne flips it out to center and carries on. Coming to the Bob Cajun line, a drop pass there. Didn't find Bezant as he had fallen. Now back comes Bob Cajun, but Bezant gets an errant puck at center ice and comes back over the line. A shot. That's steered to the corner by Zurin. There's war being waged here right in front of me in the corner. Bezant gets the puck. It's shot. Igorov tried to tip it but couldn't. Serpek backhands it back to the corner. Bartley there fighting for it for Bob Cajun. Over to his teammate Clancy. Plays it on the left side, but it's kept in. A shot goes wide. Comes around to the right side. Bob Cajun bottled up in their own zone, trying to come out with it. Can't. Now it's here on the near corner again, and finally they flip it just over the line. Bennington has it there to Serpek. Serpik, cross-ice pass. Here's a shot by Igorov. Oh, and a nice glove save made by Zurin as he was rapier quick to get that catching glove out. And a nice shot by Igorov. is just a shot on goal statistic, but that was labeled. But Zurin made a big stop on that one. Very nice. Face off to the left of Zurin, Bob Cajun zone. A shot right off the face off by Shelburne. That stopped. Out comes Anderson on the left side to Kufis. That's broken up. Now he gets it back again and gains the Shelburne line. Slides it across. Todakoff intercepts that and moves the puck forward. Here comes Shelburne on a rush. Going right in. A left wing pass didn't work, as Gavrilov tried to go in there and couldn't get the pass. Now it's kept in by Vitsovsky, but it's intercepted by Anderson. Now here's a pass for Taylor. He's going right in empty, all alone. Oh, and the shot just went wide. A golden opportunity there for Bob Cajun, as Taylor went right in all alone. But the shot was not accurate. Wasn't on goal. Went out of play. And the faceoff is outside the Shelburne line. Team's playing 5-on-5. Gillespie knocks it into the Shelburne zone. Zub tried to move it to Ozolinch, and that pass didn't work, and Bob Cajun just had a nice chance. They tipped it, but that was over top of the net. Now Shelburne regrouping at center. Ozolinch, a cross ice pass. Now here comes Verana, it looks like, on a dangerous rush, but he lost it. Gillespie gobbles up that. It's knocked in over the Shelburne line. Zub takes his counterpart, number three, out. Gains the puck nicely. Then loses it. A quick shot. Todakoff looked behind him, but had made the save. The puck is flipped out, and we have a one-on-one battle. Won by Bob Cajun, who gains the puck back behind their own goal. Now here's Armstrong with a nifty move. Banks it out to off the boards to center. Verana looking to try and start a rush. That didn't work. Zub has it now inside his blue line. Passes it across the ice. It's out to center. Shelburne with some nice passing. And then, just as I say that, there was one that didn't find its mark to Jurasek. Back in the Shelburne zone. Behind the goal. There's some bodying action there, but nothing ensued. Bob Cajun, oh, an open ice pass that didn't quite click as the shot was fanned on. But they're buzzing in that Shelburne zone now. Patterson slides it in, but Gillespie couldn't do anything with that pass. It's in the far corner. Patterson behind the goal to Gillespie, trying to come in front with it, and Todakoff blocked that pass and pounced on it. Now we've got a bit of extracurricular action in front of Todakoff after the whistle. Looks like Zub was being jolted and returned the favor with the Bob Cajun player, and they're both going off. Zub for the Red Wings. Not quite sure who it was for Bob Cajun. Didn't catch the number. But they'll play offsetting penalties here, and it looks like it's going to be 4-on-4 action. Shelburne wins the draw in their own zone. A nice pass up at center to Igorov. He's trying to go around the Bob Cajun defense. Does, and a quick shot went off the side of the net. Good try there by Igorov. Bennington carries on the battle. Tries to come out with it. Does. He's knocked down, and Zurin hops on the puck. There's no further play. Nice effort there by Owen Bennington. He's having some words now with Grauberger. I don't think anything's going to come of it. But there'll be an offensive face-off for the Red Wings in the Bob Cajun zone. Bob Cajun making some changes. Jelinski goes off. Out comes Skillicorn, and Taylor will take the face-off. Number four, Taylor's also out there. Off the face-off. Igorov has it. In tight quarters, stick handling nicely, but 1-on-3 doesn't usually work, and it didn't there. But now he checked the Bob Cajun player, but he's going to get charged, or Owen Bennington is, rather, with an interference call. So now the Red Wings will be shorthanded, and now Bennington's going to have a misconduct to add to his collection. He must have jawed a little too much with the referee, who gave him a misconduct as well. This is going to be a very dangerous time for the Red Wings. Red Wings here, as they're going to be down 4-on-3, the most dangerous penalty kill aside from the 5-on-3. Sometimes I think the 4-on-3 is actually even more dangerous because there's so much open ice. But obviously 5-on-3, you have two extra men. Faceoff looks like it's coming outside the Shelburne zone. 31.5 seconds left in the middle frame. Still scoreless. Fine goaltending at both ends of the rink. Now the referees bring the faceoff to the right of Todakoff back in the Shelburne zone, as is the case when you take a penalty. Taylor taking the draw for Bob Cajun and wins it, but the puck is niftily and deftly shot out to center. Now it's cleared back in. Bezant there for Shelburne, clears it the length of the ice nicely. Bob Cajun trying to mount one more rush before the period's over. Grauberger up to Skillicorn on the right side. He comes in over the line. 6 seconds left. Goes in. Couldn't go all the way. There's a shot right in front. Todakoff extends himself. And he really, really did a nice job. Showed his flexibility there. Now there's all kinds of extracurricular activities going out. And a stick comes out from the bench. Looks like some really intense action there down in the zone. Now some players are attempting to throw some punches. I can't make out who the combatants are, as there's a slew of bodies between me and where it's going on, 200 feet from me. However, cooler heads have now prevailed. The players have been separated. Players on both teams showing their appreciation for the skirmish. Taylor was the combatant for Bob Cajun. And Bezant for the Red Wings. So we'll have to see if that was ruled a fight or not. If it is, both players are gone. And we've got a minuscule 2.4 seconds to go here in the second period. 59 seconds remaining in the offsetting penalties and a minute 31 to the penalty to Bennington. And of course he has at least 10 to serve after that for the misconduct. However, you don't play a man short during the misconduct. There's a big discussion now at center ice in front of the benches. Referees going through their explanations, discussions. And of course, both teams send out their best lawyers to make their case about what is going on and what just happened. It'll be interesting to see what the Vasilievs are going to do here. In the third period, they've been pretty well rolling all their lines on an equal basis up to this point. But we have a scoreless tie, very interesting scoreless tie, not many of those in the GMHL, especially when you have the likes of some of the offensive players we have in this game. You know, Jacob Verana, for instance, for the Red Wings, who leads the Red Wings in scoring, has 59 points. 32 tallies and 27 assists in only 28 games. He's followed closely by Willem Opatrini, who has 56 points, 23 goals and 33 assists. And Miroslav Jurasek, number 18 for Shelburne, 13 goals and 32 assists. So when you have that kind of firepower, and of course the Bucks have their own, as I mentioned earlier, they've got some good balanced scoring as well. So you don't expect to see zeros up there coming to the end of the second period, but that's what we've got, and I'm kind of enjoying this one because of that. Well, the discussions and the legal arguments are continuing at center ice as the referees continue to sort this out. We'll have the action going back again in just a minute, all 2.4 seconds of it. Todakoff's decided to use this opportunity for a nice skate back and forth across his own end. And in the meantime, his counterpart, Zurin, is very calm and just taking a drink and taking it all in from his vantage point, also 200 feet away. The Vasilievs are letting their feelings be known here with the referees, as I'm sure John Draper is, the head coach of Bob Cajun. And you know, this really did figure to be a close matchup tonight. I really thought it would be, and that's what we're getting so far, with fine goaltending at both ends of the ice. I'm going to do a check on what the shots on goal are for you to fill you in on that at the end of the second period. But there's been good chances at both ends. Both goalies have made really, really nice saves. I think that Shelburne's had a few more opportunities than Bob Cajun. And Bob Cajun's had a couple of breakaways, but they couldn't cash in on either one. All that stood in the way of them in the lead was 6'5" Anton Todaka. He's done a fine job, as usual. Well, we're almost ready to go here, and the referee points to the face-off. Teams are getting one final explanation, and we'll have the action for you shortly. The puck will be dropped, and of course there'll be lots of discussion at the end of the period after another 2.4 seconds go by. Yeah, one of the better players for Bob Cajun tonight has been 39, Taylor. That's Kyle Taylor. Of course, they have number 4, Kevin Taylor, as well. Kevin is a defenseman, and 39 is a forward, Taylor. So, now out for the Red Wings. Looks like Levesque is going to end the period for the Red Wings out there. Camden's out there with him. But we're not lined up and ready to go even yet. Don't really know why there'd be this big a delay after a rather minor skirmish. A skirmish it was. Levesque is taking his position on the ice. Now out comes Ozilinch and big number 31, Berninghausen, for Shelburne. The puck's dropped, and we'll finally end the last 2 seconds. And we'll go to the dressing room, still tied 0-0. Two men short apiece right now, as minor penalties were called to both teams on the skirmish. So it looks like those players that were involved will be able to return for the third. Referees escorting Bob Cajun off the ice first, Shelburne being told to wait as Bob Cajun is leaving. There's a few heads turning and some jawing going on. Igorov seems to be the chief spokesman of the chirping category for Shelburne. And Taylor, no surprise there, and Patterson are rebutting for Bob Cajun as the teams leave the ice. Anyway, we'll have the third period action for you in just a few minutes, and we'll see you then. Bye for now. We're back, ladies and gentlemen, for the third period of this matchup, 0-0 after two. And the beginning of the third should be very interesting, as the teams will be playing three aside. And that's a lot of open ice to create scoring chances. So it'll be very interesting to see what happens. Opatrini with Verana and Kabelka for Shelburne. Looks like Skillicorn and Taylor's out there, but there's a bunch of Bob Cajun players, so I'm not sure who they're going to start yet. Grauberger's out there, number 2, back on defense. We're having some more discussions about the time left in the penalties in the third. The clock was running as the teams exited the ice. I'm talking about the penalty clock, so they have to be reset. Now there's 1:58 left on one side and 129 left on the other. So that has to be changed. Both teams starting two men short, two minors aside to start the third period. We're also waiting for them to change the period to number three. Still shows number two out there. The Vasilyevs are looking to see who Bob Cajun's going to start before they make their final chess move to decide who they're going to put out to start the third, although I have a pretty good inkling that they're going to put Verana and Upatrini out there, pretty good skaters and scorers. Yes, that's who's starting, with Kabelka on defense. We've got Taylor, Grauberger, and I'm not sure, I can't see the number of the third Bob Cajun player, but I'll bring that to you as soon as his sweater reveals itself to me. The game clock needs to be reset to 20 minutes as well. It shows zero as it counted down the 15 minutes that is the break between periods. Now Tim Camden's having a word with the official. And the official's now talking to the Shelburne Brain Trust, the Vasilyevs, Igor and Nikita. Jacob Bezant also looking on there. Okay, the game clock set at 20 minutes. And we're ready to go, finally, to start this third period. 3-on-3. Pucks drop, Kabelka gets it, he backhands it back into his own zone. Todakov plays it to Verana, who starts out with it. He gathers speed at the blue line, center ice, lost it momentarily, regains it again, stops at the neutral zone, back to Kabelka, ahead to Opatrini. He's winding, now breaks the blue line, but now turns back again. Still has the puck on the right side here. Kabelka back to Opatrini. Over to Verana, a shot, and that just missed the mark. Back to the point, another shot, and that was tipped out over into the meshing, so play is called. 19:22 to go here in the third period. Both teams still playing three aside, and they will do that for the next 52 seconds. Puck to the right of goaltender Zurin in the Bob Cajun zone. Opatrini's waved out, so Verano will take the faceoff. He loses the draw. Bob Cajun coming out to center. A nice move, trying to go wide on the D-man. He does, and he cuts back on the inside. There's Bartley. He's checked, and out comes Opatrini now. Left wing pass a little too far for Verana. He gets the puck in the corner. He's bodied, but maintains possession. He's got Ozilinch in front. There's a shot by Opatrini, and that didn't miss by much. The Bob Cajun goalie is well out of the net and down. He covered the puck, and it was held long enough, even though it squirted free. It was held long enough for a faceoff. This will come in the Bob Cajun zone. It looks as though now the Red Wings are a man short. 4-3. 24 seconds left in one penalty and 53 in the other, and of course 24 left in the Bob Cajun penalty as well. Face off deep in the Bob Cajun zone. Serpik's going to take the draw. He's got Ozilinch on one side. Bob Cajun looks like they've got Patterson out there. And number 20, Kalugin, back on D. We've got some more delays here. I'm not sure why, but there's quite a discussion going on between Igor Vasilyev and the official right now. Zub is leaning over the boards to try and hear what he can garner from the conversation. Todakoff going for his customary skate between whistles. Or at the whistle. All right, Serpek is going to take the draw for Shelburne. The conversation's continuing at the timekeeper's bench with the officials, all three of them over, or at least both of the referees are over there. There's explanations being given, unfortunately not to me, so I don't know exactly what's being said or why the delay. It has to do with the penalty clock and the time left in the penalty. They now have both teams still two men short, one aside for 53 seconds and one aside for 24 seconds. That's what the playoff clock is showing. Now, Camden and Patterson are having it explained to them in the neutral zone. Stick with us, people. We'll have the game back underway very, very shortly. 16:54 left in the third. It's 3-0, and sorry, 0-0 still, as teams look to be playing three aside still. A lot of confusion over there at the timekeeper's box. Not necessarily with the timekeeper, but with the whole thing that's going on here. All right, referee blows his whistle. We're finally ready to get going. 3-on-3 still. Face off in the Bob Cajun zone. It's dropped. Serpik feeds it back to the point too far. It goes back into the Shelburne zone. Ozilinch has it there. Misses Serpik with a pass. Bob Cajun gobbles up that. Now Ozilinch intercepts an errant pass, and out comes Serpik with it over center. He lost it. Now it's shot back into the Bob Cajun zone. A bouncing puck. Shelburne had to clear the zone on a delayed offside. They're back in now in the offensive zone, battling for it in the corner. Bob Cajun though has it behind their net, trying to come out with it. No luck yet. Now they do, and they come out the blue line, center ice. Now at the Shelburne line, a shot gloved by Todakoff, and he holds it for a faceoff. Team's now back to four aside. And there's only 6 seconds before both teams will be back at full strength. Face off to the left of Todakoff. We've got Camden, Cassidy, Berninghausen, and looks like 92, which is Serpik for the Red Wings. Red Wings get the puck into the Bob Cajun zone. Armstrong back there. Tried a pass but was checked. Shelburne working the corner. Now it's centered in front by Shelburne. There's a delayed penalty coming to Bob Cajun for cross-checking as the dangerous man in the slot was knocked down from behind. And so Bob Cajun will go to the penalty box, and it'll be a 5-on-4 power play as the teams were momentarily back to full strength. 5-on-4 for the Red Wings. They immediately go to their big line, Opatrini at center. He's waved out of the faceoff now. In comes Verana. Back to Jurasek. He backhands it into the corner and behind the net. In there, Opatrini looking. Turns in the corner. Trying to set up the power play. Still has it. Takes a shot. High on the short side. Nice save there by Bob Cajun goaltender Zurin. It's back in the corner, Verana with it, trying to find an open man. Takes it along the sideboards, backhands it back into the corner on the same side. There's a wage of war along the corner. For Opatrini gets it. Jurasek now has it on the middle boards. Back to the point. There's a long shot, and that went wide after it hit a leg. Shelburne maintains possession in the power play in the offensive zone. Now they lose it, and out comes Bob Cajun at center, shorthanded to the Shelburne blue line. And Anderson's by himself, makes a nice nifty move. He was dumped. Play goes right on there. Bob Cajun looking for a penalty, but none was forthcoming. Out is Ferrana at center, at the Bob Cajun line. He's bodied on the far boards. Jelinski couldn't get it out. Now, it's centered in front. A shot hit a leg. Shelburne still on it. Jurasek still out there on the power play. Comes back to Ozilinch, looking what to do with it, trying to stick handle in front. There's another penalty coming to Bob Cajun as another player was knocked down from behind. And that almost looked like a replay of what we just saw a minute and 28 seconds ago. So Bob Cajun is running into some penalty trouble here. They don't like it, voicing their displeasure with the referee. But nonetheless, when play resumes, Shelburne's going to be in the offensive zone on a two-man advantage. A golden opportunity to draw first blood. Off the face-off, the puck is shot along the boards. It goes off a glove, out of play off a Shelburne player. So the face-off will come outside the blue line. 30 seconds to go in the two-man advantage for Shelburne. They've got Tim Camden at center, Igorov on the right side, and it looks like Levesque on the left wing. Here comes Igorov, fakes a shot, passing to Levesque, a shot, that's why, but didn't miss by much. Now they try and center it, and a very, very alert play by the goaltender Zurin, who slid across and intercepted a pass and held on. Face off to the left of Zurin in the Bob Cajun zone. Puck is dropped off the draw. Bob Cajun wins it and fires it the length of the ice right on Todakov, who leaves it there. And out comes Kabelka, and a bad pass for Igorov is too far and intercepted and shot back into the Shelburne zone once again. Ozilinch back there. A backhand pass for Igorov on the left side. He's out to center, gaining speed. Hits the Bob Cajun line and is checked. Tries to regain possession and does, but it's a delayed offside on the play. So the faceoff will be outside the Bob Cajun line. One man is back on for Bob Cajun, so they're one man short for the next minute and 22. And we're bringing you all the action for the next 15:41 here in the third period or more. Puck comes back into the Shelburne zone. Zub backhands a pass on a blind wing. That went too far. Bartley's hops on it, knocks it back behind the Shelburne net for Bob Cajun. Now Shelburne has it. It's Jurasek, a long pass. Works, only momentarily though, as Verana was checked. Now Bob Cajun coming back in, and it's poked off their stick, back out to center, fired right back into the Shelburne zone. Jurasek starts up the left side, makes a move at his own line. At center, gaining speed over the Bob Cajun line. Still has it behind the net now. And it's fired to the point but not out. Zub has it, a slap shot from the left point, is deflected but out of play. Lot of deflections and shots going off bodies, out of play, and not finding the net from well out, even though they're good opportunities throughout this whole game for both teams. 46 seconds left in the penalty. Bob Cajun once again wins the draw, fires it around but cannot. Zemski keeps it in at the point. A pass in to the side of the goal. Shelburne trying to come out with it but strongly opposed. Now it's back to Zemski at the point again. Another shot, and Zurin stopped that, and the rebound goes to the left side, poked back behind the net. Now Bob Cajun has it, fails to get it out, and on a second try they do, and they fire it the length of the ice. Zemski is back for it. He passes on the left side. Verana almost lost it, but Shelburne still has possession now in the neutral zone. Cassidy on the left side, feeds it over, and now a nice pass to Verana. Going in, oh, and he's just checked at the last minute, or he could have skedaddled right in on goal. Now back comes Bob Cajun. A centering pass didn't work by number 17, Glassbergen. He's still working it behind the goal. Bodies his man, Zemski. That looked like it shook up Zemski a little bit. Anderson now to Gillespie, back in the slot to Anderson. A shot goes off a leg and wide. Bob Cage in dangerous pressure now in the Shelburne zone. Varana goes back for it. He's checked. Now Anderson in front, in a very dangerous spot. Red Wings try and clear, but can't again. A shot goes wide of Todakoff, who was vulnerable. Another shot by Gillespie, and Todakoff didn't see that till the last second. Made a good save. Now there's a nice body check in the corner on defenseman Cassidy. Back come the Red Wings. Over the line, but stopped. Back comes Bob Cage. One-man rush. A shot. Oh, and a nice glove save by Todakoff, as there was a nice rush there by Jeremy Tokar of Bob Cage. Face off to the right of Anton Todakoff, who fought off a hand injury earlier in the game. Cassidy loses the draw for Shelburne, but gets the puck and tries to hit Serpik at center. The puck goes the length of the ice, and that's icing. Faceoff coming back into the Shelburne zone. Defensively, Shelburne has big number 61, Ozilinch, out there, along with a very big number 31, Burninghausen. Back to the point, a shot deflected just wide. Serpik battles the far side, knocks his man down. Camden has it, flips it up to an open Igorov. A nice move and a shot. Good save by Zurin. They took a second poke at it while Zurin still had it, but he never lost possession, and of course, that means a faceoff. Faceoff down in Bob Cajun's zone to the right of Zurin. Played very, very well tonight. Both goaltenders, of course, have been very good in order to keep the score at 0-0. Off the faceoff, Shelburne gets it in the offensive zone behind the net, looking to try and find an open man. They can't. Patterson has it, puts it back behind his net. Now Bob Cajun will try their luck getting out again. A long pass is intercepted just at the blue line. Shelburne coming in with it again. Igorov has it to Serpik. He got tied up. Now it's dumped to center, and Bob Cajun starting back into the Shelburne zone. No sooner do I say that, and that's broken up. Serpik at center is stopped. Here's Big End. Whoa, Patterson. He fired a hard wrist shot into the Shelburne bench, and that hit one of the Shelburne players, who I don't believe, fortunately, is any worse for wear. That could have been a dangerous one. Face off outside the Bob Cajun blue line, 12:15 to go. 0-0s. Still the score. Here comes Shelburne, dumps the puck in. Nikitin ducked down low and missed a heavy check. Now Shelburne coming back in, looking for an open man. A shot from a sharp angle didn't work, as that was blocked. Shelburne keeps it in behind the net. They try and come out in front with it, but can't. Bob Cajun clears the puck to the blue line, and now out. They gain position at center. Dump it in, a weak shot on Todakoff. He flips it right back out, tried to hit number 16. And that missed its mark. Face off, once again, coming back down into the Shelburne zone to the right of Anton Todakoff. Off the draw, Bob Cajun wins it. Here's Kufis with it. He makes a nice move, dancing in front. A backhand shot by Taylor didn't work. Deflected, once again out of play. Boy, this puck is like a super ball tonight. Every shot seems to hit a leg or be deflected right out of play. As a result, the faceoff's coming outside the Shelburne blue line. Opatrini is there with Varana and Jurasek as usual. Zemsky back on D with Cassidy for Shelburne. Bob Cajun counters and has the puck to the side of the net. Kufis, a shot, that just why. It's kept in at the point. Shot around the goal. Zemsky tries to get it. He's being engaged there. It squirts free to Verana. He made an errant pass, and that was intercepted. Now a three-on-one break for Shelburne, coming back the other way. Verana, backhand pass across, didn't work. It goes back to the point. Cassidy wrists it back into the offensive corner. It shot around the horn, not out. Kept in by Zemski. Now Opatrini circles, a shot from the blue line, and that hit a leg and went wide. Verana has it. Centers in front. And that pass almost worked, but didn't. Now Bob Cajun fires it out to center. They start a three-man rush over the Shelburne line. Going in, a wrist shot didn't work, and back comes Opatrini. He hits Verana on the right-hand side. Going in on the right side, a shot. And that was turned aside. And now back comes Bob Cajun again. They get it at center. In over the Shelburne line. Fakes a slap shot. Going in, a weak shot, and Todakov catches it and holds on. We're just over the halfway point of this final frame, and it's still 0-0. Amazing. I don't know. I'd have to look up the stats when the last time regulation ended in a 0-0 tie in the GMHL. Not too often, that's for sure. Okay, Camden takes the faceoff. It's won, however, by Bob Cajun. A hard shot from the point by Armstrong. Camden gobbles up that rebound after a nice save by Todakov. Bob Cajun. Patterson has it in his own end, circling in front of his own goal. Coming out to the blue line, to center. Dumps it into Shelburne zone. Todakov off the boards. That's intercepted. It's shot in on the side. Bartley trying to center it and does, but nobody home. As Serpik now has it for Shelburne, he just clears the zone. Bob Cajun coming back in onside. They backhand the shot on goal. Todakov was equal to that as the net was dislodged. Todakov hole held on, and we'll have another faceoff. Wholesale changes coming for both teams. We've got Levesque over the boards with Vistosky for Shelburne. Kabelka and Zub on the point, and the Keaton on the left side for Shelburne on the forward line. Puck is battled along the near side here. Shelburne trying to come out with it. It was blocked by Armstrong, who was lying on the ice at the time. Now Shelburne has it back in their own zone, circling behind their net. Around the horn for Levesque. He missed that pass. Big Patterson intercepted that, dumps it back to his defense. It's tipped in over the Shelburne line, and Zub is back there for it. He fans on a pass and is engaged immediately. Patterson goes up to help his teammate forecheck. It's behind the Shelburne goal. Patterson has it. Back to the point. Here's Armstrong on a backhand. That was neatly blocked by Kabelka. Now Bob Cajun still trying to center it. Has it at the far side. A shot is blocked. They'll try it again, but that doesn't work. And now out comes Shelburne. Over the Bob Cajun line. Coming right in. A shot. And that didn't hit the mark either. Back out to the neutral zone. Nikitin shovels it back, but that pass is intercepted as fast as he shot it, and back comes Bob Cajun. It's flipped in on Anton. He clears it aside. And now it's cleared the length of the ice into the Bob Cajun zone. No icing. Taylor going back for it. Passes it up on his right wing. That's gobbled up by the Red Wings, who try and start a rush the other way. Here comes Verana, right in. He shoots along the ice. Nice save again by Zurin. Big forecheck now happening for Shelburne. A pass right in front, the open catch, they score! Here's a nice pass as a turnover happened by a nice forecheck. And the puck was gathered up on the right side and passed across. And before Zurin could get over there, it was fired into the empty cage. I believe Verana will get credit for the game's first goal. 1-0 Shelburne as they draw first blood. 7:36 to go. Puck is dropped at center. It's over the Shelburne line. It's tipped out over the blue line. Verana has it on the left side to Opatrini. Tries to feed Jurasek. That was blocked. Now Bob Cajun flip it out to center. There's a race for it. One by Bob Cajun on the left side. Ozilinch moves over to confront. And then a weak shot is easily handled by big Anton Todakov. And once again, he held on and there's no further play. Face off to the left of Todakov, deep in the Shelburne zone. Shelburne sends out Tim Camden, Serpik, Kabelka, Owen Bennington, who's back on after serving his misconduct, and Igorov, who fires it down into the Bob Cajun zone. There's a battle along the far corner. Bob Cajun trying to come out and get the equalizer. They're at their own blue line at center, an open man on the right side. He didn't see him. He fired into the Shelburne zone. Camden has it for Shelburne. Twists, makes kind of a dangerous rush, but comes out with it nonetheless. On the right side, the Serpik. Back to Camden. He's going in. A shot. Oh, nice save. As that shot was labeled for the short side. And once again, Zurin made a nice save. Here comes Bob Cajun back the other way now. It's shot in behind the net. Bob Cajun the first on it. Trying to make a play. Tried to hit an open man in Bartley, but that was gobbled up by Serpik. And now a two-on-one. Igorov with a hard shot from the left side. And that was wide. Back to Camden at just outside the Shelburne line. That pass was intercepted. Back comes Bob Cajun inside the zone. That didn't work. Back now is Igorov. He tried a backhand pass, and that hit a leg. Now it's Cassidy just inside his own blue line. He fires it to an open wing. Bob Cajun will garner it there. Engaged by Jurasek. That didn't work. Now it's coming out Patterson, trying a rush for Bob Cajun. Fires it into the offensive zone. The puck is kept in at the point by Bob Cajun. And now an errant pass comes out to Levesque, and he starts out. And now Shelburne coming in over the Bob Cajun zone, behind the net. Vistovsky with a nice rush there, but that was stymied. Now it's shot back down the ice into the Shelburne zone, too far, and icing as the pass originated from their own side of center. Faceoff will come down deep into the Bob Cajun zone, to the right of Zurin. Opatrini, Verana, and Jurasek out again for Shelburne. However, the draw is won by Bob Cajun. They flip it out to center. Big Berninghausen's there, number 31. He dumps it just over the line. There's a delayed offside. Bob Cajun had to wait. Now if Verana gets a loose puck, goes in, shoots, scores! He hopped right on an errant backward pass by Bob Cajun, went right in on the right side, and made no mistake in beating a startled Zurin. Nice goal by Verana, as it was a really nice shot. 2-0 Shelburne. 4:50 to go in the third period. Shelburne leaves the big line out. They win the faceoff and go in on the Bob Cajun line. Taylor breaks up that rush. Tries to move the puck forward, but can't. Opatrini going in now. There's a hard shot. Nice save by Zurin, and the puck goes to the corner. Now gobbled up there by Bob Cajun. Garberger on the left side coming out. Now it's in the Shelburne zone. A hard check there by Shelburne, keeps out Skillicorn, tried a shot from a bad angle, a puck bouncing in front of Todakov, but no one was there for Bob Cajun to take advantage of it. Now Shelburne gets the puck out just over the line, as that dangerous rush almost cut the lead in half. Bob Cajun at their own line, trying to regroup, was intercepted and shot back in. That's a signal for Shelburne to make changes. Out come the Bucks, at center. Overskated by Skillicorn. Takes a long, weak backhand into the Shelburne zone. Shelburne, Camden has it and dumps it out to center. Fired back into the Shelburne zone. Kabelka and Bennington back there for Shelburne. Out comes Bennington. He's on the left side, feeds a nice pass. A pass for Serpik went to the far wing. He gobbles it up there and goes in on the right side. It's in the Bob Cajun zone now in the far corner. Down goes a Bob Cajun player. Jelinski, who gets up and promptly gets the puck. Now Jelinski starts out at the blue line. A long pass here on the right side. That was broken up, and back comes Serpik for Shelburne. Nice check there by Bennington at the Shelburne line. Igorov tried to go in, but just failed. Now back comes Shelburne. There's a collision at the Shelburne blue line, Skillicorn and Camden, and the play was offside. 2:56 left in the third period. Shelburne holding a 2-0 lead over Bob Cajun. Puck is dropped, shot back into the Shelburne zone. Goes wide. Zub tried to poke at it, but that hit a Bob Cajun player. It's still in the Shelburne zone, but now it comes out at center. Shelburne trying to go in over the line. They lost it. Gain it back in the neutral zone, and they'll try right back in again and succeed. Back behind the net in the Bob Cajun zone. A nice pass on the wing. Out comes a dangerous rush led by Kufis. He drops it. Now in the slot, a shot, and that went off a leg as Anderson tried to find the marker for the first time for Bob Cajun, and that didn't work. Hard work, no, by Bob Cajun behind the goal. Anderson centers it, a shot, again blocked off a leg. Puck kept in the zone. Cassidy has it now behind the net for Shelburne. A weak backhand pass. The puck is shot down the ice, and this will be icing charged against Shelburne. Because of that, they will not be permitted to change. So the five that they had out there in Nikitin, Levesque, and the rest of the Cassidy, Zub, will all have to stay out there. Puck is dropped back to the Bob Cajun zone, point. There's Armstrong with a shot. That was weak and wide. Clancy gobbles that rebound up, keeps it in the zone. Tries to hit Bartley. That didn't work. Now back comes Levesque. He fires it into the Bob Cajun zone. 1:40 to go in this one. Third period action. Now Bob Cajun coming out with it, thinking offensively as they're down by two in the dying moments of the game. Now they're caught up the ice as Shelburne comes in. There's a shot. Nice save by Zurn as he had to go post to post to save that one and was equal to the challenge. Back comes the Bucks at the Shelburne line, offside, as they just dipsied a little too long and the doodle was ahead of the play. Face-off just outside the Shelburne zone, 1:15 to go here in the third period. 2-0 Shelburne. And Anton Todakov is 1:15 away from a shutout. But just as I say that, a hard shot off the face-off as Patterson walked in over the line. And Todakov made a nice pad save and went down to smother it. No further action. Face off to the left of Todakov. Verana, Opatrini, and we have Jurasek. On the point, we have Ozolinch, who backhands a pass to Verana, starting out with it. Clears it up to Opatrini over the line. Over to Jurasek, a shot. And that was blocked by Bob Cajun. A dangerous rush there. Back come the Bucks up to center. In over the Shelburne line. Ozolinch watching as Bartley tried to go around him. Ozolinch gets the puck, fires it up on the boards. It's cleared out. Now a long pass for Opatrini as the empty net has happened because they pulled the man for the extra attacker, and that was a dangerous rush that almost ended up cinching it for Shelburne. However, there's only 25 seconds left. A pass here. Bob Cajun comes in over the line. That was stopped and flipped out. And now we have a breakaway for Shelburne with the empty net, and they score! Jurasek was set up nicely, and he went in on the empty cage, made no mistake, and puts this one away with 13.8 seconds to go in the game. 3-0 for the home side, Shelburne Red Wings. Congratulations going all the way around as customary after a goal, we'll drop the puck and finish the last 13.8 seconds, and then this one will be in the books. Off the faceoff, Zub gets it back in his own zone. He fires it around the boards. It's cleared out to the line. Igorov has it there, a long shot into the Bob Cajun zone, and that'll do it, as Shelburne has won the hockey game 3-0 over a very game Zurin and the Bob Cajun Bucks. But an important win for Shelburne here at home early in the new year. So join us again next time for more exciting GMHL action as it comes your way. Red Wings are home, in case you're wondering, right back here tomorrow night against the Mattawa Voyageurs. This is Bob Bernstein wishing you all a very pleasant good night, everybody.